Never mind if the IRS targeting Tea Party groups was inappropriate. The Attorney General wants to know if it was criminal.
I have ordered an investigation to be begun. The FBI is coordinating with the Justice Department to see if any laws were broken in connection with those matters related to the IRS. Those were, I think as everyone can agree, if not criminal, they were certainly outrageous and unacceptable.
Criminal or not, the IRS practice of singling out Tea Party affiliated groups appears to have gone well beyond agents in the Cincinnati, Ohio office that handles tax-exempt applications, which the IRS first suggested. Jordan Sekulow's law center represented 27 Tea Party groups that had trouble getting tax-exempt status from the IRS. He shared with us several lengthy questionnaires his clients got from IRS offices in California and even Washington, D.C., which Sekulow calls excessive.
Could it be that your clients shouldn't have tax-exempt status, that they are primarily doing political work, not social welfare?
The IRS has not come to any of our clients with questions that would be in the part of the normal process. These were all delays relating to the questionnaires that are at issue here.
He says delays are still happening. Just yesterday, a Tea Party client in Tennessee trying to get tax-exempt status for 2.5 years got this letter asking for even more information. And the questions the IRS is asking troubles lawmakers. Lists of members and donors. Congressional Republicans call that unprecedented. In this IRS questionnaire, a Tea Party group is asked to provide names of donees, recipients, and grantees. That makes even mild-mannered members of Congress furious.
How chilling is it for an organization to get a letter from the IRS asking for its membership list? And that has nothing to do with the decision on whether or not tax-exempt status should be granted.
What does that tell you?
Well, it raises questions about whether there's a political motivation here.
Congressional investigators have now learned the scope of this is larger than the IRS indicated last week. 471 organizations singled out for special scrutiny. Compounding the IRS's problems, lawmakers feel misled by its leadership.
This was either one of the greatest cases of incompetence that I've ever seen, or it was the IRS willfully not telling Congress the truth.
I don't have a comment.
Acting IRS Commissioner Stephen Miller was informed of the targeting last year, but never told Congress.
Well, how about answering our questions?
On Capitol Hill today, he refused to answer reporters' questions about why.